Hello everyone, I am Shweta and welcome to my channel Analytics by Shweta. In today's video, we will learn how to create a waffle chart in Excel. A waffle chart is a 10 by 10 grid of points. If you see, we have two waffle chart examples over here. In one example, the points are represented by squares, and in the other example, the points are represented by circles. As you enter the percent over here, for example, I am entering 45% over here. 45 points are being highlighted in both these waffle charts. If I increase the percentage, for example, if I put it as 95, 95 points are being highlighted in the chart. For example, if I put a decimal point like 65.5 and I approve this. If you see, this is a decimal point, 65.5. So 65 points are highlighted in this chart. And in the next cell, if you see the square, only a portion of the square is being highlighted because I have put 0.5. So 65 points are being highlighted. And in the next square, only a small portion of the cell is being highlighted. The same is the case for the circle. You would see 65 points being highlighted. And in the next circle, 50% of the circle is being highlighted as we have written 0.5. So this is what we are going to learn in today's example. So let's go to our workings and continue. This is our working sheet. So first, whatever percent you want to enter, enter it over here. For example, I'm entering 45% over here. Now this 45% has to be converted to a number. So I select this and I say into 100. So now it is converted into a number format over here. We have a lot of helper columns over here, and these three, part 1, part 2, part 3, are going to help us in our formula. I have broken it down into various steps so that you understand the formula much easier. The first step, what you need to do is convert this 45 into a multiple of 10. To do that, what I do is I divide this by 10. So what I get is 4.5 as the answer. Next, we need to round it down completely. So I use the round down function and I say 0. I need to add a bracket over here. And if you see, I have got 4 over here. The next step is you take this 4 and you multiply it by 10. So now I have got 40. So 45, the closest multiple of 10 is 40. So I have taken 40. The second part is whatever is remaining. So what is remaining is the 5 part. So to get that, I do modulus this into 10. So this divides it by 10 and gives me the remainder. So if you see, I have got 5 as the remainder over here. Now these are the two portions which will help us in our formula. Now if you see, I have written 10, 20, 30 over here, which is helping. Now it is 45. The closest multiple is 40. So what will happen is up to 40, I want the number 10 to be represented. So it would be 10 up to the number 40, because 40 is the closest multiple which we have got. Then in the next point, which is 50, we want the remaining point to be written, that is 5. And then after that, we want 0 to be written. So we write 0 over here. So this is something which we want to achieve, but we want to achieve it in a dynamic way. So if you see here, the next point from where 0 starts is 60. So what is the difference between 40 and 60? It is 20. That is 20 points after the point, we will have to enter 0. So what I do is I select this and I add 20 over here. So these three are my helper cells which I will use in my formula. And to make this dynamic, let's start to create our formula. So I'll delete this. The first step is I say if this number over here, which is the helper number, and I just lock the columns, is less than or equal to the part 1 value, which is the closest multiple of 10, then return me a 10. So let's just look at the first part of the formula now. I have said if this is less than or equal to this value over here, then give me a 10. So I am just closing it. If you see up till 40, I get 10 because 40 is over here and 40 is the closest multiple. If I change it to 65, if you see up to 60, I get 10. Now the next part is whatever is remaining should come on the next cell. And then after that, we require zeros. So let's go to the second portion of the if formula. So we have said if it is matching, then return me a 10. If it is not matching, say if this over here helper, and I lock the columns, is less than this part 3, which is the portion where I will start adding zeros, then return me the part 2. Else return me 0. And I close this if and I approve it. Let me just drag the formula. If you see, we get 5 over here. So the first portion I have explained to you. The second portion says if this number is less than or equal to this number, not equal to, just less than this number, then return me a 5. So for the first cell, it will return because it is less than this number. So it returns me the remainder value. But once it crosses that value, it will always remain 0. And that is the reason we had given plus 20 over here. This is completely dynamic. For example, 87.25. So if you see, we get 80, which is the closest multiple, and then we get 7.25. Let us do the second portion. For the unfill, just completely start adding 10 over here. So for all the values, we added 10. For these formulas, I have used these helper cells over here and then I have connected them to these helper cells. You can directly incorporate them in the formula and avoid using this. I have done this so that you better understand how these formulas have been derived. The first step is you select these, you go to insert, and you insert a clustered bar chart. Next, you select these axes over here and you say 0 to 10. You remove the grid lines and you remove the chart title. You remove both of the axes. Now, select any one of the series to format data series and overlap it to a 100%. And also reduce the gap width so that the bars are a little bit thicker. Now if you look at the chart, we have the unfilled series completely on top of the filled series. We cannot see the filled series. So let's go to chart design. You go to select data and from here, move the filled series down. And now if you see, we can see our fill series. So we have somehow reached our waffle chart, but this is not what we want. We want it to be represented by small squares or small circles. So to do that, go to insert, go to shapes, select a rectangle shape, and then draw it onto your report. Next, put it in any color which you require. For example, I am putting it in gray color. And then in the shape outline, I have to put white. Now remember, putting it in white outline is very important, so don't miss that step. I make a copy of this and for the second one, I put a gray color. So I have a green color square and a gray color square. So I copy the green square, I go to my fill series and I paste it. If you see, I get a blur version of the bar chart. Select the bar chart, go to the format option, and in the fill, if you see, we have stack and scale width written over here. Select that and ensure one is written. Now if you see, we see the boxes over here. Let's do the same for the unfill series. We select the gray box, we copy it, we select our unfill series and we paste it. We go to series, we say stack and scale width and we say 1. So if you see, our waffle chart is prepared. Let us just delete the legends and adjust it. Now, if you see, I have written 87.25. So 87 boxes are highlighted. And in the next box, if you see, a very small portion is being highlighted. That is, the 0.25 is being highlighted over here. Now, what you need to do is just small formatting options. You would just go to insert. You would go to text box. You would select these text box and you would select the percent. Just adjust it. We would go to shape format. We would say no outline and just adjust the percentage. Now, in this, we just need to add a border to it. So I go to shapes, I select a rounded rectangle. I have just adjusted it. I give it an outline. I say no fill. And in this way, you have selected your waffle chart. You can format it and design it however you want. Now we have used squares as the option over here. You can use any other shapes how we have used circle. So let's see an example of that. I have copied this cell over here and I've copied the chart and now I'm using a circle. So I select a circle. I make a small circle over here. I use the shape fill as the green and the shape outline as white. And I copy this and I make it gray. So the steps are the same where you copy this. Now instead of this, I would put the circle. And instead of this, I would put the gray. And if you see, our circle one is also created. As you move the percentages, for example, 50%, 50 points are highlighted. You enter 48.75. If you see, 48.75 portion of the points are being highlighted. We have used squares and circles in this example. You can use any shapes as desired by you. So this is how you create a waffle chart in Excel. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell for more updates. Thank you for your time and have a nice day.